Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I've just been talking to Brother Gary Bear 049, and as a matter of fact, we've been talking almost basically every day and praying as the Lord has led us. And you guys know that I've been telling you that the Lord has been showing me so much stuff. I haven't even shared in videos. The Lord has been showing us so much stuff that, you know, we just haven't even been able to have time to even think on it and get it all figured out, but maybe 25% or 50%. But anyway, the Lord had led me and told me before to get Brother Gary on the phone and then make a video. And then again today, the Lord told me. So I just called up Brother Gary, and we've been having a great discussion like we always do, all about the end times and dreams and visions and the things the Lord showed us. And we should already been making a video today, because you know, in the past I've heard some of these professional radio shows and people talking about the end times, and of course almost all of them do not believe in the rapture. They're talking and selling survivalist stuff, gold and all this kind of stuff, and that's how they make their money, you know, selling survival for the tribulation products. But so I don't think hardly there's anybody that's doing any kind of a broadcast or you know, like an interview or anything discussing the pre-tribulation rapture. So anyway, I guess that's why the Lord wants us to do it. So Brother Gary's on here with me on Skype, and I'm in South Carolina now visiting with people, and so that's where I'm at. And Gary is back there in California, out there where he's from. So he's on here with me. Gary, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Okay. I believe everybody can hear you because I'm not using a microphone. And my speakers are below the built-in microphone, you know. I think it'll go through. Anyway, so Brother Gary is one of our brothers from another mother. And we've been talking, and the Lord has just been giving us so many dreams and visions. Well, I guess Gary almost always has dreams. I don't know if Gary's had any visions or too many visions. And me, I usually have all visions and not too many dreams. But since we met, the Lord has been giving me dreams too. That's normally Gary's MO. And we've been trying to talk about them and figure them out. And I guess we could just pray, and then we need to discuss what. Well, I think we just need to put it out there, Gary, what we think is going to happen. Basically, an outline. It's not a thus says the Lord. It's not a prophecy. These are the you know, our opinions of what the Lord has shown us through dreams and visions. What, isn't that true, Gary?
Yes, it is.
And I think we should go public with it. And like I said, this is a disclaimer again. You guys know that there's always these trolls. I don't even think they're Christians, who love to try to, you know, attack other Christians and make people look bad. So I'll say again, these, we're not making a thus says the Lord unless we say that it's a thus says the Lord. And this is really from the Lord 100%. What we're saying is we've had dreams and visions, and they're like parables. And we're just trying to explain what we think the interpretation is. Unless we say so, it's just our opinion. I'll put it that way. I guess we could. You want to pray first, Gary? What do you think?
Yeah, I think we should start off with a prayer, you know, so that the Lord would bless this.
Okay.
Roger. Work that we're about to do, and that it would, He would open the ears and the eyes of those that are supposed to hear this, and that this message is given to them.
Okay, Gary, why don't you want to start? Why don't you go ahead and pray?
I'll do it.
Great.
Dear Heavenly Father, Pastor Patrick and I come together in fellowship before you. According to your command, God, you called us to bring your word to those that you love. So we ask that those that you love would hear this and that their hearts would be blessed, God. We ask that they would have peace in their lives given to them, that you would give them a sense of security about what you are doing, God, because you are the one who is able and has said in your own word that you know all of those who will be saved. So we ask that you would undertake for those out there, that you would also keep the trolls away, that you would keep those away that would question your word, that would attack your word. God, we ask that you bless each and every one, and we ask that the Holy Spirit be given to them, those that would seek you. In the mighty name of Yeshua, we ask it. Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know, Brother Gary, while you were saying that, I mean, I thank the Lord, because it's really true. Since we met, back there at the about the 1st of August, I guess it was, or 2nd of August, we met. And then that's when I had that dreams, those dreams about the bowling pins or along in there the next day, and yeah, about the 23 being turned into a 13. As those who watch my videos, you know what we're talking about. Just now, I mean, this I just had a vision when you were praying, Gary, and what I saw is, I'll just say what I saw. First, I saw the Lord Jesus Christ, but he was high and lifted up. He was way up high and lifted up, and then I saw where the Lord was. Then I saw a horse, Gary, coming toward me speedily from on high. And then it turned into a big sailboat, like with those masts, big masts, yeah, big white masts. And I remembered the vision that I had from the Lord way back in the last year or two, where I made a video about how it's like the Apocalypse movie with Mel Gibson. Yeah. You know, and I don't usually reference movies too much, but Brother Gary, you know, I'm just going to talk to you and not to the people. How about that? Yeah, like, we're doing a radio
that's
thing.
That's right, man.
Let's do it that way.
Yeah, I do it all the time.
Right, and I don't. Right, and so, you know, the Apocalypse movie at the end, well, for one thing, they stopped doing the satanic sacrifices because there's some kind of an eclipse, right? A solar eclipse, yeah, which we're about to have one,
I
think.
Holy Spirit, brother, I want to give you witness. The Holy Spirit, I can feel it.
Yeah, when the Pope's going to speak at the UN or Congress, there's going to be a solar eclipse or something at that time. And the Jewish people, rabbis say that a solar eclipse is bad for the Gentile nations, and a lunar eclipse, or like the blood moons, is a bad sign for Israel. Of course, that's not in the Bible, but that's their tradition. But anyhow, so when they saw that solar eclipse, they stopped the sacrifices, and the guy runs away. He escapes, you know, because they release them and they try to chase him down and kill him. And at the end, they run to the beach, and then here comes the Spaniards, you know, and it's the you know, and Mel Gibson, of course, is a Catholic, and he's trying to say, you know, it's the revealing of Christianity to the savages, you know, the yeah, Indians who are cutting out people's hearts and eating them and offering them to Satan, you know, to Quetzalcoatl and all that, the winged serpent, the plumed dragon, you know, Satan. And oh, yeah, who they really worship, those Native American religions, amongst other religions in the world. Anyway, so, you know, that's what I saw. And I had a vision about that before I made a video. I can't remember what all I said, but that's the point. You know, it's the revelation of Jesus Christ. I mean, that's it. The Lord's giving me the interpretation now. Thank you, Lord. It's the revelation of Jesus Christ. You know, the revelation of Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters, the apocalypse. And the Lord has just given me that, of course, in Greek. I mean, that is the book, the name of the book we call Revelation. The yes, real name of it is the Revelation of Jesus Christ. You know, the apocalypse, the unveiling, the revealing of Jesus Christ, yes, Brother Gary. And that's what we're entering. I mean, the end of Revelation chapter 3, you know, is the end of the church age. The letters to the churches. And then Revelation chapter 4, verse 1, Jesus says to John, come up here and I'll show you things that are to come, you know, and then he's caught up to heaven. You know, that's the point where the church, you know, that's a shadow of the rapture.
Yes, it is.
That's where we're at, brother. We're in the revelation, and that's what the Lord is wanting us to do. And I didn't even think, you know, Gary, we hadn't even discussed this, and I didn't even thought about it until now. That's what the Lord wants us to call, you know, a revelation. The revealing of Jesus Christ to the world.
Yes, it is.
And that's what this is all about. This is all about the unveiling of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You know, I just feel like saying it, Gary. I'm just born in the Spirit from the Lord. And that's, praise God, because when you and I are together, the Lord is doing something different. You know, it's that double portion anointing and something new that the Lord is doing as part of these end times. It's you know, I just want to say, announcing the arrival of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords to the world. Now, that's at the end of the tribulation. And, you know, whenever you have a king coming, there's people going before the king blowing trumpets, you know, blowing those silver yes, trumpets. You know, make way for the king. Make his path straight. You know, get out of the way. Bow. You know, bow. Every knee bow to the king. You know, as the Lord would come through. In, like the kings come through the street and the people bow down. Behold the King. Here he is. And I mean, that's the announcement that we're called to give, Gary.
Yes.
Behold your King. Just as Pontius Pilate even said to the Jews, behold your King. And those Israelites, those Jews said, crucify him, crucify him. He's not our king. Caesar is our king. And that's why they've been under the rulership of Caesar all these years. They've rendered their kingdom to Caesar. That's why they are suffering the tribulation, the time of Jacob's trouble. They wanted the world to rule over them. They want the United States to rule over them. They wanted all these things, Caesar to rule over them, and rejected their real king. I'm sorry, it's Brother Gary. You go ahead.
It's a powerful thing, Pastor Patrick, that goes along with that prophecy that the Lord gave us about Nehemiah, and how that, you know, when we were together, the Lord was telling us over and over again through tongues that Nehemiah had something to do with this. And then he told you and I that I want you to write this down, but he used a word, you know, and it meant to like
inscribe.
Make a note of this, to make a permanent. And the next day you and I were talking about this, and the Lord also said that, you know, he was going to set his face like flint towards Jerusalem, and he just, you know, this, it was so powerful, you know. And then whenever I did the ending prayer there, I said, you know, I was praying that the Lord would put a wall of fire around Jerusalem, and
right.
And God would give us a secondary notice that this was actually from him, that this was a confirmation, because this is a revelation, you know, as far as, you know, you and I, when we were talking about what we believed and when the rapture would occur and those kind of things. And, you know, we thought, well, there could be a revival, or there could be this, but then God is telling us, no, there isn't. There's going to be this thing where I return, you know. And so we were really wondering whether that was the truth or not. And then you get an email that confirms this. Another brother is studying Nehemiah, and he sends us the very section of those scriptures that repeat what God told us in this prophecy to us, and which was a confirmation like we asked for. And in that, it has the word, because you and I have been discussing, what was that word? You know, we couldn't remember. And in it was the word from Nehemiah through God to inscribe this. And it was inscribed, and that was the very word that God gave us. And that's what the prophet Ezra did. He was a priest and a prophet there at the time in the temple. It was the restoration of God's temple and the walls around Jerusalem. And he was a scribe. He was a chief scribe as well as a priest, and he inscribed all these names of those that came out of Babylon to rejoin the nation of Israel and to rebuild the walls of the city and to rebuild the temple and to sanctify it and to put the things back in order, you know, that God had commanded. And that's really what God is saying. He's turning his face like flint towards Jerusalem to do as what happened in Nehemiah. That's what God's prophecy to us was, that now he's going to restore Jerusalem. He's going to restore the priesthood. But we know that the word of God tells us that many lives are going to be lost in Jerusalem before that happens, you know, and this all has to take place as part of Revelation. After the church is gone and his spirit is removed, we see that God is going to restore the priesthood back to Israel through the 144,000
right.
And the two witnesses. But first, two-thirds of Israel will be destroyed. Those secular Jews that do not worship God, do not have any love or desire to worship the God of Israel, but
right.
Only those whose names are written in the book. And I really believe that's what God is showing us here, that
right.
The rapture is going to... And you know something, Pastor Patrick, the date, we're coming up on the date that the walls were completed and the temple was sanctified. And that date is right near September 9th through the 11th, somewhere in that area. Those things were completed, and God told those men that they were to sanctify the temple, and they were to praise God, and they were to make this as a holy day, though no Jews really celebrate the rebuilding of the second temple, which was, you know, the temple that Solomon had. So it's just a beautiful thing here that God's
right.
Doing.
Amen. Amen, Gary. You know, I just feel the Holy Spirit so much on all this. You know, we talked about too, well, as the Lord leads, I mean, we, you know, I had a dream that I shared in the video. I did share a dream a little bit, you know, about this woman announcing, it was actually a, you know, a Gentile woman that's in the spirit of Antichrist, but she's not a Muslim, but representing the Muslims, declaring that she, you know, that the Muslims would wipe Israel off the face of the map. And then yesterday when we prayed, I had a vision of the angel of darkness, Satan, standing on top of the cabal, standing on top of the cabal there in Mecca, and all the people were like demon possessed, and just the hordes, demonic black hordes of semi looking humans, like black zombies, going around that cabal. And that's what they do there in Mecca. And then what they're doing, it's a symbolic, and I made a video 2 or 3 years ago about this, you know, it's symbolic of a stargate. And then we talked about, and then we talked in the natural about how, you know, CERN is like that. We're talking about a stargate, you know, opening the pit, the bottomless pit or whatever, like, you know, where those hordes come out of there that sting people, and the stings are for 5 months there in Revelation. And the captain over that bottomless pit is Abaddon in Hebrew, or Apollyon in Greek, meaning the destroyer. And that's why it says in 2 Thessalonians, the son of perdition. That word is Apollonia. It's also the same root word of destroyer, the son of the destroyer, the son of Satan, or Lucifer is the destroyer too. And you know, this is his son, the Antichrist, the son of perdition. And it says he goes into destruction, goes into perdition, Apollonia. So, you know, that's the other thing that the Lord was showing us. So this is saying to me and Gary, as we've been talking, as far as the rapture and all that, I mean, this part of it is saying that the war of Gog and Magog, I believe, or people talk about the Psalm 83 war, you know, whatever, that Bill Salas, I think is his name, who wrote a book about it and all that. But it looks like the war of Gog and Magog is what is also going to happen this September, you know. And then Gary and I discussed, and Gary can talk about it more, you know, we believe that will probably, you know, lead to the peace treaty. And I talked about that on my videos way back when I first started, that, you know, the Muslims will never make peace with anybody. We know that, unless they're in charge and we're under Sharia law. But the Antichrist will make peace. So during the war of Gog and Magog, in Ezekiel 38 and 39, it says 5 out of 6 of their armies will be destroyed. And so that's the Russians, Rosh, Tubal, Tublinsk. That's the Russians and the Persians and whoever else who will be in on that coalition will try to attack Israel, and God will send down fire from heaven, and 5 out of 6 of their military will be destroyed. So we believe, I believe, and I think Gary's in agreement with me, that when that event happens, that, of course, will astonish the whole world. It's going to bring a stop to everything. You know, the oil and all that's there. The whole world's going to be in an economic crisis and a halt to everything. And it's worldwide effect. And then that's when the Antichrist will be able to come to power. But before he can take power, as Gary already referred to, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, the restrainer, which is the Holy Spirit through the church, it's not the Archangel Michael, as some of these false prophets on the internet are saying. The Archangel Michael is an angel. He is not God. He cannot hold back, you know, the spirit of darkness or evil. He cannot restrain evil in the world. Only God, the Spirit of God, can hold back evil. You know, Michael is an entity. He's not a God. He doesn't have the ability to be omnipresent, as only God can do. So God, the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, the Ruach Kodesh, the Ruach Elohim, he will be the one to be removed from this earth at the rapture that we talked about. You know, the removing of the bride. And I'll just say that because there's always people that watch and say, oh, the word, they heard that the word rapture is not in the Bible. The rapture is just a Latin word and a theological term to talk about the snatching away that the Bible tells us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and referred to in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, like verse 50, 51, 52, 53, along in there also. That we would be changed in a moment in the twinkling of an eye, and we'll be called up to meet the Lord. Okay, Brother Gary. Now,
yeah, what I wanted to go back and talk a little bit more about this Nehemiah thing, because I believe it's so important. Because this was the second time Solomon's temple was rededicated, and it was the second time it was rebuilt. You know, people look at the two temples, the actual second temple that they talk about, it's in Jerusalem, which was made by Herod, and that was destroyed. But the real temple of God, you know, the thing, the core of that building that Herod built was this temple that Nehemiah was in when they restored this thing. And God really sanctified that. And there was only, and I feel the Holy Spirit, there was only so many people, Patrick, that agreed to this and came out
right,
of that.
On.
You see, these people, there's records that show one of the priests said that he had a daughter and a wife, and he was, the saddest day of his life was when he had to go back to the temple because he had to leave his beautiful wife and daughters behind.
Gary, are you saying, to break it down for people, are you saying that you know, just a remnant of Israel is really going to come to the Lord and get right with God?
Yes. That's exactly what I'm saying. The Word of God tells us through prophecy that two-thirds of them will die.
Right.
Because there are so many secular people that have invaded God's land of Israel. And they call themselves Jews. And they have DNA that says that they're Jews and all these things. But what the Lord looks at are those who love Him.
Right.
God
Almighty wants those
who love Him. And He wants to restore Israel because the covenants were made to Abraham. And God, see, this is the purpose, Patrick, as you and I have talked of God, of Satan trying to destroy the Jews throughout all history. And that's why this wicked arm of Islam has said that Jews must die, because it's written in this book that they believe in, and it says in there that they have to come in and destroy them. And they're saying, even as far as yesterday, the Ayatollah came out and said that the Jews must be destroyed because Israel, and Jerusalem in particular, is the third most holiest site in Islam. So they must, according to their own beliefs, they must destroy the Jews out of there. And the reason that is because Satan is trying to make God's word of none effect. God's word was first to Abraham, and he made all these promises, and then to Jacob, and to Isaac. And so we have these things that God promised these men, that they would do all these things, and that we know that the Old Testament says that there would be this other temple, and it also says it in the New Testament. So these things are supposed to happen in that area, in Jerusalem, and so Satan believes if he attacks them with thermonuclear weapons, there's radiation, they can't build a temple, they kill the Jews, and that makes God's word of none effect, and so that he can make God a liar. You see, that is his purpose, is trying to prove, disprove God's word, just like he did in the very beginning with Eve. He came to Eve and said, "Hath not God said this?" And then she says, "Yeah," and he says, "No, the really reason is God's a liar. He knows in that day that you eat, you'll be a god like him." That's him from the very beginning, trying to make God's word a lie. And that's what we have going on right now in the world. You have the world's forces, including the United States of America, except a few senators and a few Christians that are on Israel's side, people that really have no power. Obama has crowned himself as king, and he has said, "Hey, I'm going to give these guys a nuclear weapon." That's
right.
His determination.
Right.
And the reason is so that he bring about all this this destruction upon the land. And the only way they can do it is if they have those weapons. They are the arm of Satan on earth, and they are trying to destroy the Jews, which they will. Two-thirds of them are going to die, but those are going to be the secular ones, and the ones that love the Lord, that truly love Him, whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life, those people will be saved through the tribulation period and whatever else. They are going to be saved. And that is the joy that we can have. Like you were saying about the Ruach HaKodesh, you can trace that throughout God's word and how that is truly is the restrainer that was given to the church and now lives in us. So for that Holy Spirit which lives in the believers to endure through this tribulation period is impossible. God will not allow that. He never allows His people, His spirit, to go through that kind of thing. I mean, it's just, there are more scriptures than we could talk about during this brief time about how, what God's plan is and how He has made a way, you know, to save His people through the catching away, which was spoken of so many times and so many examples were given, you know, even with Moses, like we were talking earlier, how Moses went up and he saw the land and he died, but he did not see corruption. He was taken at that very instant. So it's just a beautiful thing that God has shown us about how Israel is going to be restored as the apple of God's eye, and that they are going to be, you know, Bible prophecy is going to be fulfilled, because it says in the last days that 10 men would go to a Jew to get the thing, but no more, because it's going to be, all men are going to know at the end of this thing.
Right.
It's going to be this powerful, you know,
right.
This just wonderful thing that God is doing, which a lot of people see as destruction and these things, but we have to realize that these people chose to do this. These people chose, and that God is involved in all of this, and He is the one that loves and makes this thing happen, you know, for salvation for those whose names
right.
are written in the book, and
right.
and He's just revealing this thing over and over to you and I.
Right. Well,
about,
Gary, oh,
it's me. God's
yeah,
telling
yeah,
us it's
amen.
Me. You know, even Patrick, with your dream that you dreamed about us being in that van and being taken. See, it was not us doing it. It was God doing this thing. God showing us, even His ones that He is really using, like you and I giving us words and telling us these things. It's not really us. It's God.
Amen.
Giving this to us. You know what
right.
I mean?
Right.
It's a powerful thing.
Right. You know, I was just thinking of, the Lord has just given me, while you've been talking, the Lord has given me revelation to go back to what you said, you know, really that Obama is the one who's empowered Iran. Well, you know, think about this too. I mean, this is what the Lord was showing me. Number one, of course, everything's ordered by the Lord. I mean, the theme of Daniel is, you know, God is sovereign over nations, you know.
Yes,
as an example, and we're talking Daniel, we're talking Babylon and all that, and end times. The visions and dreams Daniel had are actually linked with Revelation. You got to, if you want to study Revelation, you have to study it with Daniel, particularly as the
yes.
number one source.
Daniel said, "For the end times,
right.
seal this up for the end of days." And we know
right.
what time we're living in.
Right. Well, you know, think about this. I mean, since all the nations in the Middle East, those Muslim nations, have been destabilized and all been let loose of their secular dictators for the jihadists and those who really hate Israel, the vehement, you know, satanic forces to rise to being in charge. But even this, Gary, as the Lord was just speaking to me while you were talking also, that look at Iraq. I mean, in the natural, it made no sense, as anyone that follows these things would know, like what Donald Trump said, and I've been saying it too. I'm no military expert, but Iran and Iraq were balancing each other out in the Middle East.
Yes.
And
yes,
then,
amen.
And then under President Bush, not Obama, even before that, God had it designed that Iraq would be taken out of the way. I mean,
yes.
Iraq being removed, allowing the Persians, this war of Gog and Magog, you know, opening the door.
Yes.
You know, the Lord says in Ezekiel 38 and 39, the Lord is just reminding me, Gary, in that text, it says, God says, I will put a fish hook in their mouth.
Yes.
And I will pull them. He will compel them
yeah.
to attack Israel.
Yeah.
And that's
through
you know,
their word, through their thing, through their book.
Right.
It's
what you're saying, right.
They cannot be good in their religion. They cannot fulfill their religion unless they fulfill the jihad against God's people.
Right. It says you find, you know, kill the Jews and Christians where you find them. You
yes.
know, this tree will say to you, hey, there's a Jew hiding behind me.
Yes.
You know, it says in the Quran.
And
that's what the Lord is saying. I mean, Gary, I mean, we're getting these different pieces, and we're discussing several different pieces all as one. You know, we're looking at the whole map, you know, and the Lord
yes.
has given us all these pieces. And so we can make a video on all this stuff. We should make a video of what we think is going to happen. Let's do that in there. And maybe I feel like the Lord wants us to keep doing this, maybe even every day or what. But so what do you think is going to happen? What do we think is going to happen? Do we want to say that? I mean, what do you think is in your own opinion?
Well, I think, you know, you could talk about what we were just talking about earlier and how you laid this whole thing out, this scenario about how, you know, we believe that, you know, that you're going to have this simultaneous things happening, just like you saw in that vision of the bowling ball striking those pins, those heavenly pins. You see, Patrick, that really was from the Lord, because those things were heavenly things, brother. That's
right.
What God told
yeah,
you,
true.
The heavenly up there. That's why the pins, I say the pins were, hallelujah, I say the pins were made out of stars themselves.
Right.
They weren't made out of the earthly thing. They were made out of the stars of heaven, because God declares in the heavens what's going on. And if you notice this whole thing with the woman clothed with the sun and the moon at her feet and all these things, God has shown us that these things, and He's told us in the Word that in the past, Almighty God set the heavens We are in the place on earth in our solar system so that we can look up into the heavens and see these things that God is playing out on earth for the whole game. This whole ball of wax that's being played for is written in the stars. And what you saw those bowling pins made out of stars, and then written on the bowling pins were these dates that God has preordained to happen. And that's why whenever you said, hey, this thing starts down on the 18th, that is exactly what happened, because the rest of that is going to happen too. And it was God that didn't allow you to see all of those dates, because those things are to be revealed later, but that people could know that it's God Almighty himself saying this to the people, saying, hey, listen to me. I wrote this in the heaven. This is a divine thing that God's given. That's why it's the stars. Those are divine things, those stars, and that's why the pins were made of that. Pastor, that's
Amen.
What the
Amen,
deal is.
Brother.
That's why they didn't look like wooden bowling pins with numbers written on them or anything else. They were stars, made out of stars themselves.
Right. That's a good one, Gary. I didn't even think about that. That's a good one. You know, the Lord
that's
keeps giving
God,
us so
man.
Much.
I'm telling you, I heard that.
God keeps giving us so much, Gary. Line upon line, precept upon precept. We haven't shared 90% of the stuff the Lord showed us with anybody. And I believe that the Lord wants us to share it with those who have an ear to hear, who can understand the things of God. And of course, you know, and that's the thing that the Lord had told me too. You know, you see this, you know, the people, we call them trolls, and people that downvote anything. But they don't have an ear to hear. They don't understand. You know, they can't understand spiritual things. It's only in the natural that they understand these things. And so what I think is going to happen, just to say it in the natural, is because I had a dream that was already been fulfilled by an individual. I had a dream of an individual, but also about the business world. And in that dream, there was shaking, and then it seemed like it was going to fall, and it didn't fall, and then it did fall. And I think that's reference, we're talking about the economy. And then I had another dream that I haven't made a video about, of being in an airplane, and the plane kept diving, going back up, and diving and going back up. And every time it would dive, more people on the plane would begin to call on the name of the Lord. And that's really, brothers and sisters, that's the point. I mentioned this in a video the other day, the last video I made, I think, where people are worried about the natural, and there's nothing wrong with, well, you know, if you own stock and you own, you got your money in dollars or savings or whatever, there's nothing wrong with praying and asking the Lord what to do with your funds, but if you want to get those kind of unbiblical, secular ideas, you know, you got to listen to those people like Steve Quayle and all those guys that don't believe in the rapture, who have their Bible interpretations all messed around there, and they're focused on, you know, preparing to survive the tribulation. When God has called us to prepare to meet thy God, you know, prepare to meet the Lord. You could die in a car wreck today. I mean, you could be killed in an earthquake today. You could be shot by some nut like that goes on every day now in this demonic infested world that we live in. You know, and stop worrying about what's going on in the stock market, but take it as a sign to tell people, hey, it's sooner than you think. We were all thought it was going to be the Shemitah, but it's already been going down. Even though it's going back up a little bit, and it probably will be the giant crash and complete crash out on the Shemitah and all that, but it's already happened some, and it's a sign from the Lord. You know, get your eyes on things above. You know, set your affections on things above. As Brother Gary was referring to about these bowling pins. Stop looking around you at the storm like Peter did and get your eyes on Jesus. Because that's the one that we need to be prepared to meet thy God. That's the message. And, you know, that's what makes me so upset and spiritual, you know, righteous indignation. When all these people that saw my video are all concerned about the natural and about the stock market and all of these things. God's not sending those things for you to be worried about what's going on in this world. The Lord's sending these things that you might know that there is a God in heaven, that you might know he's the Lord over all creation, all events, he's sovereign in all things, and he's coming back to get a bride without spot or blemish. He's going to take us to be with himself in heaven. And it's sooner than you think. That was the message that the Lord sent about the bowling pins and about the stock market, this you know, this tremors that we've seen and a partial plunge and now a slight recovery before the great collapse, before the great tribulation, before the tribulation hits in the next few weeks or months or whatever it's going to be, seems to be coming at this time in September and all that. In my opinion, it seems that it's going to be in September or October, let's say, this fall. But in the meantime, it's sooner than you think. The Lord is coming at an hour that you think not. At the midnight hour, the voice cried out, "Behold, the bridegroom cometh." He's coming at an hour you think not. It's sooner than you think. Prepare to meet the Lord and stop preparing to deal in the world and prepare to deal in heaven at the judgment seat of Christ. Go ahead. I'm sorry, Brother Gary. Go ahead.
That the Lord is saying, you know, and you've got this, many people have got this, about the third day. And the whole point was, on the third day, it says in Ezra, they completed this. You see, they completed that temple. And it said in there, when Moses was talking about meeting his God,
right,
the people were all going as one accord to meet God. And God said to wash themselves,
right,
and do all these things, and to stay away from your wives on
right
the third day,
right,
because you're about to meet God Almighty. And it's about sanctification. That's what God is trying to tell these people, and that's what you're trying to tell them right now. It's not about the signs that point to him coming, but it's about his actual coming. These people, you know, people want to see all this flash. And give us some garbage. Give us some dirty laundry, because
right
that's what we want to see. But they don't want to see God is coming and that they have to be sanctified, that they
right
need to seek God. They need to get down on
amen
their face and repent and look for all their sins that are in their lives and repent of those. And even those secret sins that they don't know that they've committed, they need to ask God, get in my heart and make me ready. And that's what Paul was talking about, and what Christ was talking about, where he said to pray always that you're counted worthy to escape all
amen
of these things.
Amen.
And he
amen
just talked about those things that we see that are considered to be the tribulation period. Christ himself, and that's another big foot in the face of those that preach there is no rapture, there is no catching away, because he said, pray always that you are found worthy to escape.
Amen.
These things that are coming.
Amen. Luke 21:36. Amen.
Man.
Amen, brother. Amen, brother. Hey, brother, this video's, I don't mind keep going, but I'd like to just go ahead and finish this one up, brother. Because I want people to, you know, just more people to see it and hear the message.
Get it out there. Today may be the last day.
Right, I know. Amen, brother. Amen. I want to get it uploaded. I'm excited to load this video because I know it's from the Lord, man. This video is commissioned by the Lord.
Yeah, I talked to the Holy Ghost like 3 or 4 times, man, while we were talking. And when you were talking, it was just powerful.
Amen. When you were talking about all that stuff about Nehemiah, I mean, that's the thing about it, Brother Gary. That's your part. God is really using with the Israel part. And when you're saying it, the anointing is so strong. But I, even myself, I mean, I don't fully understand what God is saying other than he's going to save a remnant of Israel. But that's like your area. And then the Lord is leading me, you know, to bring in the priority to speak it plainly. The priority is to get right with God. You know, I mean, that's the point.
Yeah.
Be ready. Be rapture ready.
Oh,
I mean,
yeah, man.
I mean,
be ready.
We could talk for hours, but who cares? We had dreams and visions that came to pass. So what? What has that got to do with you and the judgment seat of Christ? You know what I'm saying?
There you go.
You
know, yes,
hey,
amen.
Amen. God just gave those things that you might know that we're hearing from him and that we're
amen
speaking by his authority, by his grace, and by his spirit. That's the only thing they are. Signs and wonders following those who believe.
Right.
It shows that, hey, these people are, these Brother Gary and Brother Patrick are my servants. That's all it shows.
Amen.
You know? I've given them power of attorney.
Just like they are. That's
right.
All. We are exactly like
just
they
like
are.
Just like any born-again, truly born-again
right
Christian. That's right. Amen. Amen, brother.
They could walk where we walk if they wanted.
Right. They just got
to
go meet.
All you got to do is lay it down, man.
Right.
Get before the Lord on your face.
Right.
Cry
amen
out to God. Hey,
amen.
He
amen
promises that, Brother Patrick. In the Word of God, he promises, if you do this, then I will do this.
Right.
You see, if
yeah
you lay down your life, if you prostrate yourself before the Lord,
right,
and you love me with all of your heart, soul, and mind,
it's
and you
exactly
pray
right
me,
yeah,
I will
yeah
answer.
Jeremiah. Yeah, call upon, Jeremiah 33:3, call upon me, and I will answer
yeah
you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. That's all
amen
we've done, is called on the name of the Lord, right?
Amen.
And he answered us.
And he wants every one of us to be like that.
Amen.
He wants 10,000 Patricks and Garys out there, 50,000, all of us to be that.
Right.
Just like he did, brother, in the beginning, when he said, look, there it is again, hallelujah, glory, ikam the bahasi, ina the bahashan the bahakaya, ikulu the boshua siya san the bahakai, ikulu the boshua siya san the bahasiya. Patrick, it's just like the Lord said there with Moses. He said, I called all of Israel to be
right
priests unto me.
Amen.
He wanted all of them to be sanctified, but they rejected it.
Right.
They rejected God in fear. They said, no, don't let him get 270 from us to go up there before
right,
you.
Right, right.
But God wanted all of those men and women
right.
to be priests
Amen.
Unto God.
That's the same word that was coming into my spirit from the Lord. I want to give a witness to that. That was the exact same word I heard from the Lord. Yeah, he wanted all of them to be kings and priests. But they would not. They said, let Moses go up there. We don't want to go up there.
Yeah, I'm telling you, man, it's powerful.
Amen, brother. Amen, that's exactly right. Well, let's keep doing this, and let's pray. Let me do a closing prayer, brother, because we're at 40 right. minutes. But I mean, like I say, I don't care, but we're going to keep doing it.
Save some souls, man.
Amen.
I know. Don't be changed.
I know this is what the Lord wants us to do. Praise God. Praise God. I'm going to pray. Father, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, your only begotten Son. Hallelujah, Father.
Amen.
We come before your holy name, Father. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for the double portion of anointing, Lord. And Lord, we talk about revival. We're talking about revival on those who are going to go to heaven, those who will be saved.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is sending revival to those who will be saved. And to those who have a deaf ear and a hard heart, there is no revival. It's for those, as Gary said, whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life from the foundation of the world. Hallelujah. According to thy word, Father, according to thy words, even as the Lord Jesus said, you didn't choose me, I chose you. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Jesus said, no sheep comes unto me unless my Father draws them unto me. Hallelujah. Praise God, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you called us unto yourself. All those who have an ear to hear, all those listening to this video who are Christians, I want you to praise the Lord God Almighty because he called you and chose you and allowed you by his grace, by his spirit, by his blood, by his stripes to be healed and delivered and set free in Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God, Father. We thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit. Lord, we ask you to bless all those who are watching this video. Bless them with ears to hear and eyes to see. Hallelujah, Father. We praise you. We praise you. We honor you, Father. In the name of Jesus. God bless you guys. May the Spirit of the Lord be upon you today. By the grace of God, Brother Gary and I will continue to make these videos. God bless.